Hi children, welcome to grade 5 science. Today we are going to discuss about the disease chapter 6, right? So what is disease? Any illness that causes disorder in our body and makes us to feel sick. So that is called disease. And what are the causes of disease? The disease is caused due to three main reasons. Those three reasons might be microorganisms, lack of nutrients, and improper functioning of body organs. Right? Microorganisms are very minute organisms that can be seen under the microscope. They will be found in water, food, soil, waste, etc. Right? Some of the microorganisms are bacteria, virus, and protozoa. And the diseases caused by these microorganisms has been already discussed in previous sessions. Right? So next one is lack of nutrients. Nutrients are the available vitamins, proteins present in the food that are needed by a body to do a work. So what are the nutrients? The nutrients are proteins, vitamins, minerals, iodine, carbohydrate, and fat. These are the minerals that are available in our food, right? So whenever the proportion of these nutrients will be lower in some times, that might also cause diseases. That situation is called lack of nutrients, right? Malnutrient in sense, it will be categorized as undernutrients and overnutrition. Undernutrition in sense, diseases caused due to insufficient nutrients in our food, right? For example, the diseases might be Kawasaki marasmus, and overnutrition is due to over-consuming of particular nutrition, such as fat. Over-consuming of fat leads to obesity, right? And also we had discussed some of the diseases related to this lack of nutrition. That is, lack of vitamins and lack of proteins, and also what are the food sources that are rich in these vitamins to overcome those diseases. These had been discussed in previous sessions. Next, the third reason is improper functioning of body organs, right? So improper functioning of body organs in sense, due to the age fact, our body parts may not function properly. And due to that improper functioning, it leads to some disease, right? That tends to be improper functioning of body organs. The diseases might be arthritis, heart attack, and cataract. Arthritis, it comes mostly in knee, which is tends to be knee pain. And heart attack, it is due to improper functioning of heart. And cataract, which will comes in eye, in which a white layer will be formed in the pupil of the eyeball. Right? This is the symptom of cataract. Mainly, it comes in old age people. Since their body became weak and immunity level also very low, they suffer from this disease, right? Then we discussed about types of diseases. So what are the two types of diseases available? Communicable and non-communicable. Communicable in sense, it is easily spread to other person from the infected person. And non-communicable in sense, it cannot be easily spread to other person from the infected person. So communicable diseases, highly contagious. It is also said to be contagious or infectious disease. Example for communicable disease are flu, tuberculosis, chickenpox, measles, cold, etc. And example for non-communicable diseases, night blindness, beriberi, cancer, scurvy, arthritis, heart attack, etc. These are non-communicable diseases. And today we are going to see about spreading of diseases, means of spreading of diseases, how the diseases can be spread from one person to another person. That is how the communicable disease can be spread from one person to another person. Since communicable disease can be spread from one to another, so how it will spread? Yes, with the help of mosquito, with the help of air, with the help of water, with the help of objects the infected person use. So these are the mediums through which the disease may pass from one person to another person. Here we go. So, means of spread of diseases. So, what might be the medium by which the diseases can be spread? The medium are air, water, sexual contact and other animals, such as insects, other insects and animals, right? So by air, what type of diseases may spread? They are common cold, pneumonia and tuberculosis. By water, the diseases might be cholera and dysentery. And by sexual contact, the diseases might be AIDS and syphilis. And by other animals, the diseases might be malaria, dengue and chickenpox. The most common creature that transmit the disease from the infected person to the normal person is a mosquito. Everybody might know about this, right? Because of mosquito only, we will suffer from malaria, typhoid and dengue, right? Very good. Chikungunya too passed by, that is transmitted by mosquito. So it is an important creature which transfers the diseases from the infected person to the another person. Since the protozoa carried by these mosquito will directly mixed with blood. Okay, so when the mosquito pass bites on person, it sucks the blood of a infected person and it bite another person. In such a way, the blood from the infected person will passed into the bloodstream of a normal person. So the normal person also affect by the diseases. Common protozoan diseases. In such a way, the protozoa organism will be transferred from infected person to a normal person. Right? So how we can prevent these communicable diseases? Let's see. We should maintain a healthy, good hygiene and we should be very proper. We should be very clean. We should drink clean water. We should eat good food, right? And we should use mosquito repellents in order to get rid of mosquitoes. Okay. And what might be the other? That is, maintain good personal hygiene. Drink boiled and filtered water, right? We should drink boiled water and do not let water stagnate or stand to prevent breeding of mosquitoes. You might have seen in rainy seasons that water may stagnate in some places. That is, puddle of water may seen on the road. Okay, since it is dump. Okay, so in such conditions the mosquito may breed in that water, so we should avoid such water to stagnate near our house. Okay, due to water in the drainage also will cause for the breed of mosquito, so our drainage should be clean. Okay, so use mosquitoes net and other pest repellents and do not dump garbage in the open to prevent breeding of house flies. We should not dump garbage in the open place. We should put the garbage in the particular provided place, right? Avoid coming in contact with persons suffering from communicable diseases. We should not go in contact with the person who is affected from this disease. Do not use the belongings of persons suffering from the communicable diseases. We should not use the affected person's handkerchiefs, towel or anything else. Right? So these are the measurements by which we can prevent the communicable diseases to transfer from one person to another person. Right? We might have seen the microorganisms are harmful to us, right? So some other microorganisms are very useful to us. So they are bacteria, that is lactobacillus, which helps in settling the curd, right? In this way, the bacteria will helpful for the organisms. Okay, not all microorganisms are harmful to human. Some might be very helpful to the human, right? So this is our last session. We came to last part of the session. That is your homework. You have to complete the practice zone 3 in concept book and MCQ part in your workbook. Okay, we can meet in next session. Till then, stay safe, stay connected.